Guys, something just happened which absolutely blows my mind. One of my quick clips just went over 10 million views. It's absolutely incredible. Now this is a video showing a concept where you can take a AA battery and a gum wrapper and use it to start a survival fire. It's a really cool idea I first saw in Household Hacker, and yes, it actually does work. Now here's the challenge. While reading through the comments, I noticed a lot of you were having trouble with this at home because it was either burning your fingers or wasn't lighting off at all. So the purpose of this video is to dive into even more detail so you fully comprehend how it works, and then we'll use that technique to start a fire out in the desert today. Now the trick to actually getting this to work lies within the gum wrapper itself. So I stopped by the grocery store and picked up 3 different packs of gum so we could compare. What we're looking for is a wrapper that has a shiny metallic exterior, but a textured fibrous interior, something like this. And you're also gonna need a AA battery, which you should be able to find in all different kinds of electronic equipment, including flashlights. Now you probably know by now that a battery has a positive end and a negative end, and if you use something conductive to connect the two ends, electricity will begin to flow. If we think of electricity like water, then the voltage coming out of the battery is like the pressure of the electricity, and the conductor that we're using is like the tube or the piping that takes the water to where we need it to go. If we use a thick pipe like this, the energy can flow relatively freely and nothing really happens. It's just gonna get the battery really hot and burn your fingertips. Ooh, ouch! But if we make the size of the pipe thinner, the electrical pressure and resistance build up to the point where they actually generate a significant amount of heat. And it is a little bit of a balancing act, because too thick and it won't light off at all, too thin and it just burns in half. We're trying to find that sweet spot where it goes up in flames every time. Now what I found works best for me is to take one of your gum wrappers and cut it lengthwise into thirds. This will make 3 different igniters. When you've got those pieces cut, trim it in from the sides to form an hourglass shape so that the part in the middle is about the same thickness as the blade on your pair of scissors. If you've done it right, it should look something like this. Now here's how to get your improvised igniter to work. Take your 4th finger and rest it underneath one end of the igniter so that the foil is facing up. Then take the bottom of your AA battery and press it down into your finger so it holds the foil in place, and use your thumb and forefinger to hold the battery straight up like this. Now this last part happens pretty quick. We're going to take the top piece of foil and press it to the top of the battery with our thumb and hold it vertically until it bursts into flame. When I made my quick clip, I used this big 5 gum. It works really well for me and I've got it to work almost every single time. But it does make me wonder how other gums might compare, so I picked up some Juicy Fruit and Orbit just to see if there's any difference. Opening it up here, and the first thing I notice is it's actually got a paper exterior here. There's no shiny metallic side to that at all, it's just paper. And if we open that up, it's just paper as well. So just based on that observation, I do not think that Juicy Fruit is gonna work. We need a shiny, conductive metallic surface, and paper is not gonna do the job. Now to be fair, I'm gonna cut this up and try it anyway, because we can't really be sure of the results until we put it to the test. All right, here we go. Contact. And nothing. Our hypothesis is confirmed. Paper is non-conductive. No success with Juicy Fruit, we're gonna try Orbit next. And here's the reveal. Yeah, and these ones are just covered in paper as well, so pretty sure those are not gonna work. Probably better put them to the test just to be sure, but I already know they're not gonna work, and these ones are a little bit too short, so they probably won't reach the battery terminals anyway. Ooh, barely. We can get it to reach, but barely. That's as good as it gets. No reaction. All right, Orbit's doesn't work. It's not gonna save your life. Very interesting, guys. We have been able to confirm that only the gum wrappers with the foil on the outside seem to work as our igniters. But that's not all. If you want to get these things to work, there are 2 more things you need to know first. First of all, the way you hold your battery actually makes a huge difference. If your igniter makes contact while your battery is being held horizontally, most of the heat will dissipate upwards, reducing your chances of this thing actually igniting at all. But when you hold your battery vertically, the heat transfers up into the material, greatly increasing your chances of ignition. If you're one of the people burning your fingertips when trying this, the other thing that's good to know is rip off little pieces of your gum or pieces of the cardboard box. You can use these pieces as insulation to protect your fingertips when the foil makes contact. So now that we have this technique mastered, let's go ahead and gather up some dry grass and sticks and see if we can use it to start a fire. That went up in no time flat. Easy. Cool, guys, let's put the gum wrappers away and talk about what we've learned so far. We found that in order to get this technique to work, we needed to use wrappers that had foil on the outside and some kind of a fibrous material on the inside. We also discovered that one wrapper could be used to make at least 3 different igniters. We cut these wrappers into an hourglass shape and saw just how important it was to leave the right thickness in the middle, because when the bridge is too thick, it doesn't light off, and when it's too thin, it just snaps apart. Cutting them to the width of one blade on our pair of scissors seemed to be just about perfect. We found that if we hold our igniters horizontally, the heat dissipates upwards and they're less likely to go off. But if we hold them vertically, the heat is captured into the material where they go off nearly every time. Finally, we learned that if the ends of the battery are heating up and burning your fingers, you can simply rip off pieces of gum or cardboard from the box itself to use as insulation to protect your fingers from any burns. As a side note, I did try ripping about 8 gum wrappers into igniters, but unfortunately I wasn't able to get any of them to go off. That's it for this experiment, guys. Thanks for joining me for this video, and I'll be looking for you in the next one. Talk to you then. That went up in no time flat. First try. 'Cause I'm Batman.